entitled, the ayes have it. Scott.
Fellow Toastmasters, in the next 10 minutes, you're going to be able to walk away from this session with at least three tools that you can use immediately to have a positive impact on your thought process. These proven, repeatable strategies that I'll share with you have been marketed in 2 New York Times best-selling books and in 1 Area Contest award-winning speech. You'll learn how to implement these strategies so that you can stop your negative thoughts, that you can have a more positive outlook on a daily basis, and so you can start each day off on the right track for success. Joel Osteen is a New York Times best-selling author who wrote a book called The Power of I Am. In this book, he talks about a concept where our thoughts are always focused on what comes after the words, I am. I'm not that talented. I can't take on that role. I'm not athletic. I can't go to the gym and work out. I don't really know anything about that topic, so how could I present a speech on it? Any of those thoughts sound familiar? What Joel talks about is using the concept of I am and infusing positive affirmations behind it. I am confident. I am able. I am strong. I am fit. I am willing to learn. Now, those sound a lot better than the first couple thoughts that I talked about. If this seems like it'd be a difficult task to try to implement this into your daily life, then I want you to remember this quote from Ohio State football coach Urban Meyer. And he uses this quote a lot. He says, discomfort breeds growth. If you practice this concept for 20 days, it just may become a habit for you. I decided not too long ago that I was going to implement this into my daily routine. And what I've done, so when I get in my car to drive to work in the morning, it used to be a stressful occasion. I'd be getting on the freeway. What's going on? What the heck? This is the passing lane. Come on. Don't you people know how to merge? By the time I got to work, I was pissed off. Now, by adopting this concept, my car has become a period of Zen for me and meditation for me to start off my day. Here's what I do. First thing I do is stop my negative thoughts. I just tell myself to stop. Then I take a deep breath and observe my body's presence. And then I proceed to give myself positive affirmation. I am strong. I am a leader. I am fit. I am capable. I am loving, caring. I am compassionate. And you won't believe how much me walking into the office has changed now compared to when it was several months ago. When I walk in and I see the girls in the office, happy Monday! How you doing today? And if they're like, ugh, have so much to be grateful for. We are so blessed. Last March, I attended the Area 14 International Speech Contest. And there was a young man who presented a speech that he talked about how he had a profound impact on his life by adopting an attitude of gratitude. This young man was Ben Parkins, and he talked deeper and further about that concept. And he said, if you can change your I have to's to I get to's, what kind of positive impact can that have on your daily outlook? I have to go to work tomorrow. I have to go see my family tonight. I have to go to the store this week. I get to go to work tomorrow to provide for my family, to have benefits, health benefits, vacation time. I get to go see my parents tonight, show them my love and appreciation for them. I get to go to the store and fill my fridge with wholesome, nutritious foods for my family. Doesn't that, just changing that one word, make a huge difference? There's an old adage that says, each of us become what we think most about. If we can infuse positive thoughts, positive affirmations into our daily routine, think of how much better each of us can become. Dr. Christiane Northrup wrote a New York Times best-selling book where she talked about the concept of the three most important words that each of us can say to ourselves on a daily basis. Does anyone have an idea of what those three words might be? I love you. She talks about a technique where you get up in the morning and you're going through your normal routine to get yourself ready for work or to do whatever you do during the day. You're putting on your makeup, brushing your hair. And you look at yourself in the mirror, right into your eyes, and say, I love you. I love you. Those are powerful words, aren't they? I mean, we say those words how many times during the week to our wives, husbands, significant others, kids, family members. But how often, if ever, do we say that to ourselves? Claude Bristol stated that thought attracts that upon which it is directed. My challenge to each of you going forward tonight is this. Take just one of these techniques that I talked about tonight and implement them in some way into your daily routine. Take the next 20 days to make this a habit and see just how it affects you and especially the people around you. Take that time to stop your negative thoughts, improve your daily outlook, and to start each day off on the right track by letting the I's